$33 million. It has to come from somewhere, which means tough decisions are ahead. For the Minneapolis School District, its single largest cut, $6.4 million of funding. Here's how that money breaks down. Those funds support roughly 350 district jobs, teachers, counselors, and several others. By doing so, Superintendent Ed Graff says it's trying to create a sustainable learning environment for all students in the coming years. But that decision puts all of those jobs at risk.
Many parents and students were not pleased with the move, so they decided to do something. They packed Tuesday night's board meeting and voiced some serious concerns and pleaded with board members to use reserve funds until they found a better option moving forward. The board agreed, promising to restore the money for now.
So what's next? The district still faces more than $16 million of cuts during a two-phase reduction to several programs, but with a final vote on the budget in June, the jobs will stay in hopes of finding a solution that keeps both sides happy.
Yeah, so funding for schools and budgets are being tightened around the country in school districts.
Yeah, that's a big deficit to make up.
Absolutely, and so Minneapolis isn't unique in that sense, but although this specific problem is about a budget gap, you saw teachers around the country marching in protest for teachers' pay. On that note, Minnesota ranks 19th in the nation as far as teachers' pay is concerned.
Well, that's pretty good. At least that's on the upper half of that.
Yeah.
Dylan, thanks a lot for following this for us.